Today's topic is how to add keywords to your GMB and to your website. Made easy, made simple, easy to rank. Welcome. Hey guys, I know why you're here. I know why you're watching this video. I know that you are a determined business owner, an entrepreneur at heart. You're determined, you're fired, you're smart, you're savvy, and you want to grow your business this year. You understand that by ranking on the first page of Google is the new way of getting calls, of growing your business. So in this video, I will show you how I was able to rank my client in just 28 days. We literally got him to number one in just 1 month. I will show you in this video how I was able to strategically place his keywords on both his Google business profile and his website. And this was our result. So stay tuned, enjoy this video, grab your pen, grab your paper, and take some notes. We're about to start. So to be able to rank this client in a 50-mile radius, we had to make sure that we had the right primary GMB category. As you know, the right primary GMB category is the number one ranking factor. So go to a Google, open a Google Chrome browser. For those who are SEOs, I recommend that you use the GS location changer. It's a Chrome extension that I use. I live in Georgia, my client is in Texas, so I had to make sure that I had local results. What's going on right there where he's at? And if you're a business owner and you're at the location, simply just put in your keyword. So for foundation repair in his location, we found out that the actual three pack had a GMB category for concrete contractor. This is a primary GMB category. I like to use GMB everywhere because it highlights the primary GMB category, and that's what we're after. As you can see, the primary GMB category is concrete contractor. Now, my client doesn't want any concrete related work. He does not like to do concrete. He actually has to refer it out. The point is that you have got to find out what Google is assigning for the primary GMB category for your keyword. You just have to think like that. Our next step in helping rank this client in a 15-mile radius for his keyword in just 28 days, we have got to take a look at GMB titles. As you know, keywords in the GMB title is a huge ranking factor. So let's take a look at this example. He wants to be number one for foundation repair. You got to take a look at the three pack. Are those listings are ranking you in the three pack using your keyword? Well, if they are using the keyword, you have got to use the keyword. If not, it's going to take you too long and it's going to take too much money to outrank it because Google is rewarding those listings that have the keyword in the title. I do have a video that teaches you exactly how to go about changing your GMB title, in fact, rebranding your business. So go take a look at it. If you want to rank in a 15-mile radius, if you want to break proximity, you have got to make use of Google reviews. Google reviews are absolutely fantastic. Oh my God, they're working so well. You just need to encourage reviews. Ask your clients to leave your review and to make sure that they use the keyword. That's what's going to drive the relevance. By getting keywords in your area, establishing your geographical dominance in that area by making use of very good relevant reviews. Oh my God. Oh my God. You have got to come back and tell me how that worked. Our next step was to actually add keywords under products and services in his GMB. So take a look at what we did. It's a beautiful and easy way to add relevance to your GMB and make sure that you include all of your keywords. You can simply go to products and services like we did with this client for house leveling, foundation repair, commercial foundation repair, residential foundation repair, and so forth and so on. They are services, but we added them under products. You can add beautiful graphics, it's your choice, but it's a great way of pushing relevance, and actually Google rewards you for it. Let me show you another example. You see this right here under services? You see the list of all his services? So this is a beautiful way of optimizing your GMB, adding keywords under products and services for better rankings. Guys, word of caution, please pay attention.
If your industry is moving companies, towing companies, garage door repair, locksmiths, I would not recommend this method. I would not recommend adding any products and services because I personally have seen some suspensions. There are some GMBs that by nature, they are in the spamming industries. And so anything that you add or remove from your GMB, God, sometimes even just changing your URL will cause a suspension. So again, if you're in one of those niches where, oh my God, you just make a little change and you get a suspension, do not add products and services. Any other industry, I think, is fine. So play with it and be cautious with it. Our next step in helping this client rank in a 50-mile radius is using GMB posts. This is a great and fabulous way of pushing relevance for your keywords. I have a video that tells you all about it, how you should do it, but just take a look at some of the things that we did for this client. We create a beautiful graphic that is inspiring trust. It's inspiring, you can trust me, I'm local. I am here for you, I'm here to help you, I'm here to get you the results that you're looking for. Create graphics like that. Next, use your keyword, hashtag or no hashtag, incorporate your text and create a call to action. You'll love it. Google will reward you for it. So now keywords in your website. Where do you want your keywords to appear in your website for better local rankings? And where do I make sure that my keywords appear when I'm trying to rank my own clients in the local space? Well, as you can see, this SEO ranking factor list will give us some insight. First and foremost, you want to focus on your domain. If you're a new business and you're able to get a domain with your keywords, that would be fantastic. If you already have a business and you don't have a keyword in your domain, we can talk about the URL structure. There's a way of making sure that your keyword appears in the URL. Next, very important is your title tag. Second to that is your meta description, all of your headings, your H1, your H2, your H3, clearly in your content, the first 100 words of your content, and all your images need to be alt text with your keyword. So how do you go from where you are right now to where you want to be? Well, I'm here to help you get the results that you want. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up, subscribe for more content like this, and please leave me a comment down below. Let me know what you want to hear. Let me know what your thoughts are about keywords and ranking. If you want to contact me about anything, any specific question about GMB ranking and Google 3-pack, shoot me an email, send me a text, give me a call. I'll be more than happy to help you dominate in your industry. Until next time, happy rankings. Bye-bye.